Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's been almost 2 weeks since I uploaded a video. There's a lot that happened. We got a trailer. I tried to wrap it and I failed. I'll show you some pictures here. So the trailer is parked for now. We're gonna deal with that later. The car is more important right now. So I worked on the car for a bit. Well, not for a bit, probably every day. We finished the brake lines. I finished the fire extinguisher lines. So I had to make all new hardline. And I got these for the fronts. I just have to secure it. There's more brake lines over there. There's the fire line here that goes over there. But today we're going to be installing these shock travel sensors from LowDoller. And there's a shifter, also sensor. So let's do the intro and start to it. Yeah, so I was saying, we did the brake lines and I have to get another master. The shaft of the master was bent, so it damaged the master, so I'm gonna have to get another one. But the brake lines are done. Proportioning valve, line lock, all the hard lines you've seen in the last video. But today we're going to install the shock travel sensor. I already put one in here. So this will tell the ECU where the shock is. It's gonna tell it how much is extended and all that. So I got these brackets from LowDoller and the shock. This is a 8-inch extended shock. While we're back here, I even ran the lines, the CO2 lines. So this is what's gonna control the shock. So you can see there's a little eyelet there. We replaced all the bolts, so all the bolts are NOS bolts. So you can look that up. NOS bolts are very strong bolts. They're, I think, stronger than ARP bolts. They're literally everywhere except these two here. These are AN bolts. They're almost as strong. Yeah, so the shock travel sensor is gonna tell the ECU where the shocks are, because we're gonna start, we're gonna run a radial on this car, and the suspension is going to have to extend when we launch. So it's very important to know how fast it's extending or if it's extending at all. I also got this little guy here. So this here is going to go on the transmission shifter mount. So this is going to tell, it's only 2 inches. I'm coming. Yeah, so this is going to tell the ECU what gear the transmission in. The reason we use that is when I shift from first to second, I have to pull some timing or else it blows it, it spins the tire. So that's why we want to know exactly where the gear is. I ordered the driveshaft. Big shout out to Driveshaft Chop. They're helping me out with the driveshaft, so that's on order. The shifter from M&M, thank you, Induction Performance. Shifter from M&M, the red one, CO2 with the mount pull. That's gonna be here, I believe, tomorrow. I got a bunch of stuff on order. The, what do you call them? Collector tethers. I ordered the Zeus. The battery, thank you to Go Lithium. The battery is on order. So the battery will go here. 16 volt battery, it's only 9 pounds. Here's a picture of it. That's on order, that'll be here soon also. I think that's it for now. The block is about 3 weeks away, so the head is there, so I think we're looking really good for now. But let's stop this here and we'll start installing that travel sensor. All right, so sensors are in. Let's give it a try and see if we lift them up at fully extended how it's gonna look. Want to make sure that the sensor doesn't bottom out. So there's basically at right height because it's lifting the chassis now. Yeah, this sensor is about 8 inches long of travel.
So you can see there's quite a bit left. Ideally, I want less of shock showing. I think we're gonna have to lower the ride height a little bit, but I wanna wait till all the weight. Is in the car. The Lexan's still there, the doors, the engine, and then we'll see exactly how low it's gonna sit. So the back is done, finally. The whole rear section is pretty much done. I have to set up the instant center. I have to buy the software to be able to set that up. So, good time to talk about something new. We got two major sponsors that are joining on board. They're helping me with some funding. And I'm very excited to announce these two major sponsors. So one of them is Centerline Motorsports. They did the powder coating, they did the fabrication, they do intercooler piping, they do all sorts of stuff. I'll leave the link below. Give them a follow on Instagram, on Facebook. These guys are helping me out. Big thanks, Renee. He's helping me out with some stuff on the car. So he's gonna have a sticker on the rear bumper. He's gonna have a sticker on the front bumper. So we're very excited to join with Renee at Centerline. So please give him a follow. Another big sponsor that's joining this year is Race Me Online. The website just started. I don't think I wanna link it yet, but I just wanna give you guys a heads up what's going on. Race Me Online is basically a company that there's a site where you put a drag in your car and you race people online. I'm very excited to join these guys. They're gonna have a sticker on the rear quarter too. And you'll be seeing me shouting them out a lot. There'll be hashtags on every post. So this is gonna be the first one. I'm gonna link the website. I'll link the website below. Just check it out, see what you think. And we'll talk about that later. But for now, we're gonna try to install the LowDoller gear sensor. I don't have fasteners for it. The fasteners are a different size. They're not a quarter. It seems like they're a weird size. And I need to make a bracket here. I don't wanna make some steel bracket. I wanna buy a piece of maybe thicker aluminum or very thin steel. So unfortunately I won't be able to install that. I think I'm gonna have to stop it here, and I'll get the shifter tomorrow, the M&M shifter. Beautiful piece. So I think I'll make another video tomorrow. So for now, thank you very much. Follow my sponsors, help them out, and I'll see you guys later.